Checked into my hostel. It's called Hostel of the Sun, and it's pretty cool so far. Really funky inside and bright. So I always like to stay at hostels that are funky like that. I feel like you always meet the coolest people there too, and the people at the front desk were already so nice. And I spoke Italian with them. We had the whole conversation about what to do at the hostel and where everything is and checkout and all that in Italian. So I feel super proud of myself, and I'm so excited about it. Ciao.
Ciao.
So yeah, super excited and happy about that. I'm just going to grab a juice or something, and then I'm going to meet up with Nina. So Nina is a subscriber of the channel, and she's been subscribed to me since way before I moved to Italy and when I was back in Toronto. I'm just so excited to finally meet her. We've chatted on Snapchat and Instagram and all that. So, you know, if any of you want to reach out to me, sometimes it takes me a little bit, but I'm, oops, a little bit bright there. I'm definitely always try to answer. Wow, this is so refreshing. It is lemon and orange, and it is so good. It's exactly what I needed right now. So I'm going to quickly sip this up, and I'm going to stop by my hostel and just drop off some things, and then head out to go meet Nina. So our first stop was Toledo Metro Station, and this is one of the most beautiful metro stations in Europe, and it was so stunning. It's actually won the 2013 LEAF Award for the best public building. It's designed as if you're starting undersea, and then you move up through land, and then of course into the galaxy. And what would a trip to Naples be without checking out beautiful Vesuvio? Next, we headed down to the Napoli Lungomare. Lungomare is actually another word for a promenade that runs along the sea, and it was absolutely stunning. Everybody was out enjoying the day. Along Lungomare is a beautiful castle called Castel dell'Ovo, and legend has it that many years ago this castle did not exist, and in its place there was a beach. Parthenope, a mermaid, took refuge on the beach, exhausted after having followed the ship of Ulysses, the king warrior. Before dying, the mermaid left an egg at the point where the castle stands today. And according to the legend, the egg is located just below the building in a golden cage. And from that comes the name Castel dell'Ovo. The castle is free to go inside, and the views from the top are absolutely spectacular. The way the sun hits the sea and it sparkles, it's absolutely breathtaking. After spending some time on the waterfront, we decided to head back until Il Centro di Napoli to check out the Duomo di Napoli, which was absolutely breathtaking, as all Duomos are in Italy. Every time I visit a new church in Italy, my mind is just completely blown of all the beautiful art and architecture. It just makes you wonder how many people put effort into this and how many beautiful artists were all a part of this project. I just left Nina and her mom, and they were honestly so kind to me today. I am so grateful. They showed me all around Napoli. We saw so many things actually. I'm going to go into more detail. I think I'll probably
voiceover and show you guys everything because I don't want you to miss anything. It was so beautiful, so much. I don't know, honestly, everywhere I'm going in Italy, it just blows my mind. I just feel more and more like I'm just supposed to be here because it truly is my favorite place in the whole world, and everywhere I go, just I fall in love even more. And I really can't imagine leaving, and when I think about leaving, it makes me upset, so I'm just not gonna think about it anymore. But my plan is to come back. Buongiorno, friends. I'm just leaving the hostel. It was a really nice hostel. I definitely recommend it to anybody who's traveling or like backpacking sometime in the near future, especially if you're staying a couple of days, because it's one of those hostels where the reception is 24 hours, which is great, which means that you can check in and check out anytime and get help with anything you need. And also they have a games room. They had a bar that was open till 12. Very fun and friendly, funky kind of hostel. I like those ones. I feel like they really get everybody into the traveling mood, and they encourage everybody to get out there and chat with each other, so that's great. Breakfast was also included, and I got to sit there and have the most gorgeous view of the Neapolitan rooftops, and there was a little basilica in the background. I had a coffee. I actually ended up getting an espresso after, and some orange juice and peanut butter toast. I'm now off to go meet Nina again. It's about 20 after 7, and I'm going to catch the train towards Sorrento, but I'm going to get off at Pompeii because today we are going to explore Pompeii, and I'm so excited. Nina told me it's actually one of her very favorite places, and I just can't wait. I feel like this is a dream. Like, I've thought about this so many times, and I just love history, and especially Italian history. You guys know that I love it, and I just have to say again, yesterday was a total dream. It was stunning, absolutely stunning here, and obviously a new Naples was gonna be nice, but every single place I visit in Italy, I just fall in love all over again. I definitely know that Italy is where I need to be. And Nina said to me, she's like, you just belong to Italy. And that's the perfect way to put it, is that I belong to Italy. I just feel like that. I feel like I am truly my best self here. I'm just happy every single day. And it doesn't matter if I'm walking down the street and, you know, I see a Vespa, I get excited. I'm walking down the street, I see a balcony with, you know, a palm on it and some beautiful vines, and I just light up inside. Or I see a little Italian man sitting there with his little Italian dog, and it just melts my heart. Or somebody says ciao Bella and I can't handle it. I love everything about this country. And sometimes it upsets me a little bit because I think about how come it's so difficult to live here. Well, it's not so difficult, I guess, because I'm going to get the visa. I'm going to be able to come back here legally. But you can love a place with all of your heart, but there's restrictions. Like, it's hard. It's, you know, it's paperwork, it's stress, it's all these things. When you just love a place so much that you, like, I will market Italy for the rest of my life, and if they could only hire me as like a word of mouth marketer slash like YouTube marketer for the country, like that would be dream job. That would come so easily to me. But anyways, enough about that chat. I guess I should also say that I'm still dreaming about last night's pizza, which was the best pizza of my entire life, 4 euro, and I'm not just saying that because it was the Eat, Pray, Love pizza parlor, I'm saying that because it was literally the best pizza of my entire life. I can't even describe to you the sauce, it was just amazing. It wasn't acidic at all, it was so perfect. And I met a woman there, and she was from Brazil, and she's trying to get her residency in Italia right now, and we have the same story. It was so cool, we're sitting across from each other, and she's like, so like, you know, what's your story? And I was like, well, in the corporate world for a few years, it wasn't for me, and so I quit that and I moved to Italy. And she's like, same thing with me, and it's just so cool. I always seem to meet the most fantastic people. Yeah, the most fantastic people traveling. So I hope that any of you out there who might be nervous about traveling by yourself or going out for dinner by yourself, you know, you wind up meeting the best people. You just have a smile on your face and be friendly. So I'm gonna head off to the train and I'll show you guys the views.
I was left to my own devices. Many days fell away with nothing to show, and the walls kept tumbling down in the city that we love. Great clouds roll over the.
He has a home, right? You think?
I think he's living here.
Hi. I don't want to disturb him.
I think he's a little sleepy.
Oh, he's excited.
Are you going to?
Good girl. Looking after the animals is good.
Oh, he. Oh.
Aspetta, sta più qua.
We were caught up and lost in all of our vices. In your poses, the dust settled around us, and the walls kept tumbling down in the city that we love. Great clouds roll over the hills, bringing down.
After checking out the amazing ancient ruins, we headed into the town of Pompeii to get ourselves some lemon sorbetto, and it was absolutely amazing. These are the size of the lemons from Sorrento. After that, Nina and her boyfriend Ludovico took me to their town of Castelmare di Stabia, and this is on the other side of Vesuvio. If you're looking off into the ocean there, you can also see the Isle of Capri. The waters were crystal clear and so blue, as you can see. I feel like I could have stood there forever staring at it. It's just too good to be true.